Hello, water signs. This is Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces. This is going to be your weekend read. So it's from November 11th through the 13th, 2022. This is what we're going to do. We are going to pull some tarot for all the water signs. Like I said, it's Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces as the collective. And then we're going to pull individual yogic path cards to see each sign, what's coming up with the cards. So let's go ahead and get into it. So far you have the Queen of Swords, so seeing through things, cutting through masks, things like that, seeing clarity, truth. Let's see what else. So more into your logical mind. Let's see what else we have. Page of Pentacles, yeah, okay. So there's some kind of clarity here. Oh, we have two more, okay. So there's some kind of clarity, in this, with inspiration moving forward in the material world, something that you're passionate about, you're very clear about it, you're removing the disillusionment and stuff like that. But there's something you're holding on to a little much. This is holding back, you know. This could be like, you know, your heart being guarded. That's what I really feel, because you have the Queen of Cups reversed as well. So it looks like, you know, it's like it's holding back a little bit. And I'm seeing like that Cancer, like that shell where the crab goes in the shell, or the Scorpio who stings because, you know, that protection of that shell. But this is like holding back something here, holding back something that's you need to be vulnerable with, or open up more, or let your heart, like that compassion, come out. There's something that you're holding back a little bit, okay? There is some kind of action you are taking. You're seeing the clarity. The mind's right. You just have to balance it out with those emotions. So what we're going to do is go ahead and get a yogic card for Cancer and see what this is about. All right, Cancer, let's see. What is this regarding with Cancer this weekend, please? What is this regarding? Okay, so we have Bhakti. Interesting, Bhakti. And that kind of reminds me of like compassion, open heart. That looks like the heart, and this is that full moon eclipse we just had. So, you know, trusting your intuition. Of things that are hidden, because the moon is all about hidden, but when it's full, it's more illuminated, right? So through this full moon and Taurus eclipse, I really feel like you're going to get some energy downloads, some healing, to be able to, you know, get that clarity, and maybe even to let your guard down and open up that heart a little bit more. So let's go ahead and read this card, Bhakti. You find it, Bhakti. Might be on the next page here. Let me find it. Okay, here it is. 81. Okay, so for you, Cancer, this card is all about devotion. Yes, okay. You have been begun walking on the path of devotion, Bhakti Yoga. You are devoted to something greater than yourself, your body, your possessions, or your desires. This dedication is to the divine. Now is the time to ask yourself, what does divinity mean to me? When do I feel close to the divine? Paths to Bhakti Yoga include kirtan, devotional mantras, meditations, and prayers to the gods and goddesses, offering service to those in need, and spending time in nature. The selfless path of Bhakti Yoga takes you to the greatest ecstasy of all, the bliss of devoting yourself to spirit. Okay, so this is all about like giving back, being of service. So now, if you take yourself out of what happened to you, you know, closed off, this closed off energy, if you take yourself out and start using what happened to you as a conduit to help other people, you know, so take yourself out of yourself, you're out of your pain, and put it into compassion for others. So I feel like this is a being of service. And believe it or not, I just put on my community page where there's so much people out there, and animals and things like that, are so much in need just for basic survival skills. So this is taking yourself out of your problem and putting it into helping others. So using what's happened to you as a catalyst to help other people. So this is what it's telling you, okay? So it's time to stop focusing on your pain, what's happened to you, the, you know, and start putting it into, you know what, I can use this as a benefit to help others, okay? All right. Yeah, see, it's time to take that risk and start a new journey here. So I'm really feeling this energy, Cancer, like whatever trauma or wound or whatever has happened to you, it is time to use that to help other people. So face those fears, put yourself out there, be vulnerable, and do that, okay? So I love that, I do. Yeah, so it's time to go start looking for like a volunteer group or anything like that to do. All right, so let's go ahead and get into Scorpio. Scorpio, let's see what's coming up with you. So So we have, you know, seeing the clarity and being inspired in the material world, being creative, using it for creation, but you're still a little held back here. So it's time to like somehow open up that. So let's see what's coming up for you, Scorpio. Okay, well, we have two. We have this one come up right. So we're going to take this one. We have Manipura. Interesting, Manipura. Let's go ahead and see what this Manipura is about. Let me see if I can find it. Let me see. Yeah, this is almost like, look at all that energy coming out of her head. But she's at peace with it. So let's see what this is about, Manipura. Manipura. Okay, so it's the chakras. I love that. 53 chakras. All right. So it's the solar plexus chakra. Okay. So it says, you have come to a place where you know exactly who you are. Gone are the days of confusion and blurred lines. See, I told you it was like a lot of thinking. It's coming out of her hand like peace, like there. All right. So you have grounded into your essence and built the foundation of your empowered self. You have had to let go of many friendships and relationships that were no longer serving you to get where you are, and was all worth it. Now is the time to really go after what you want in life. What do you care about? What lights you up? What do you want to serve? Meditate on these questions and ask you, take action on what comes up. So yeah, see, so it's finally getting out of that, being like in yourself. You know, it's time to share your gifts. So, and you also had karma. So we're going to go ahead and read this karma card too. You got two. Let's see, Scorpio. And it is your, you know why you deserve it. It is your birthday month, right? So let's see, karma, Galeon. All right, sorry. I have weirdness to me, guys. Sorry. 23. Karma. Positive karma. You have done a lot of good on this planet, and the universe is rewarding you for your favors. Life feels a little easier, a little more colorful, a little more beautiful. You're walking on the path toward your dharma, which creates the greatest karma one can experience. By saying yes to the purpose of your soul, you are saying yes to the greater power of the universe. Continue devoting your life to the service of spirit, and life will continue to unfold its wonders. Okay, so yeah, the universe and spirit are like really lining up behind you. You've done a lot of work. They're trying to reward you. It's time to put yourself out there and go for it. And this is like a being service for others too. So I love that. Okay? So you know, solar plexus chakra. It's very good energy. So let's go ahead and see what's coming up. That's too many. They had like, we're gonna get a couple cards here. Or one card. Couple cards here. All right, so we did get two. Okay, so we have, yeah, High Priestess. See, standing in your highest self. Yes, following your soul's path. Okay, no more dwelling in these eight of cups, this disappointments. It's gone, baby. You know, you've already walked away from it. It's time to start living your best life, you know. So that is your energy, Scorpio. So now we're going to go ahead and get into Pisces. Anyway, Scorpio, you have like a higher purpose here to start going towards. You know, you've done the work. It's time. So we have Samadhi for you, Pisces. Samadhi. I love that too. Look at that energy. Just like peace, tranquility, bliss. Okay, so this Samadhi for you, Pisces, is about eight stages of yoga, advanced state of meditation, and absorption in the self. Have you noticed the signs of spiritual progress? Your daily practice has brought you to a place of stillness, and this is where you experience Samadhi, the joining of all aspects of your being, physical, spiritual, mental, and emotional. Samadhi is the deepest level of awareness that you experience supreme bliss, consciousness, and enlightenment. Your human consciousness has become one with cosmic consciousness. And your soul has realized that there's far more than a mind and body. Celebrate the reunion of your soul and spirit, for you are a microism in the macroism. So, yes, this is coming to that, know that you're co-creating with the universe, that you're a spiritual being. I feel like this Taurus lunar eclipse has really kind of really pushed you ahead a little bit. So this is like, you know, once you gain that, like forgiving other things, and I really feel like you are to that point, Pisces. Forgiving other situations and people, I think you're going to be good to go. Like this is aligning to your higher self. This is working from your higher self. So you are already a very compassionate sign for human beings, but it's just kind of like releasing that ego part where you feel like hurt by people around you. It's coming to that almost like that servant healer type energy where you are connected with the universe and do the work for the universe or God or whatever you believe in. Okay, so let's go ahead and get a tarot card here. Yeah, so a lot of you I feel like have really tapped into your highest self. Yeah, see? So there's some clarity coming in. There's some kind of moment, and I really feel like it might have got released with this lunar eclipse that's been just happened on the 10th? No, the 8th. Yeah, so really work with that energy. You know, if you need to do any rituals or anything like that, I think it would be good for you because there's some kind of really clarity of who you really are, that you're a soul in a human body and, coming grounded with that so you can do the work of the universe and spirit. Okay, so that is your message, Pisces. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you have a beautiful weekend. Take care. Bye.